Hello, I'm Stephen Woodcock. I've been a financial markets professional in the City of London for over 30 years. Going to take a look at what's going on around the markets with maybe a little bit of a prediction for the new year. Initially, we've had a quiet Christmas period. What I'm looking at the moment, dollar wise, is we've had a small dollar sell off over the Christmas period, but I think that's linked to a bit of safe haven buying in the safe haven currencies, the yen, the Canadian dollar. I think we'll see that undo in this new period. And what are we looking forward to at the moment? Well, I'd say the two topics on the horizon at the moment are we're still looking at the US-China trade talks and obviously the impeachment situation with Donald Trump, with maybe an eye on the November upcoming elections. And I think the tide may have turned as to whether, you know, people think that he can be re-elected. I would say, you know, at the end of last year, I'd say a month ago, people were certainly talking with the impeachment there that there's no way that he could be re-elected. But I think with the way the US the US economy has performed, certainly over the last year, citing obviously the stock markets, the Dow, S&P, you know, they really have performed very, very well compared with their global counterparts. So I would say certainly if the mood of the impeachment disappears and we get some more optimistic outlooks, I think the possibilities are we see the Dow certainly go up to test the 30,000 level. S&Ps keep breaking new levels and onward and upward. Even though we are at levels where you'd say you wouldn't want to be buying it here, if you like. But I'd suggest that if you've already got a position and you'd be adding into that, certainly looking for bigger numbers. He's still going to maintain his stance. We're still going to be looking at, you know, he's going to be calling for the Fed to cut interest rates. I'm not sure if they will, but that is what the tack that he's going to be playing, I'm sure. And if there is the chance of maybe more Fed cuts, then I'm sure the stock markets are going to be the ones that will benefit from that. The dollar itself, I'm a buyer. I have been for for some time now, but we haven't seen the dollar rally. What we've seen the dollar pretty much stay around its levels, trading around. I mean, dollar yen when we came into last year was pretty much where we are now. Euro dollar and cable, I think they've been more Brexit. They've been pushed around by Brexit a little more. But the general tone of the dollar is remaining firm. And when we get to the bottom ends of the dollar ranges, the dollar finds its feet and feels very solid indeed. So for the new year, what I'm personally looking at is that the impeachment talks, I think, will disappear. I think Brexit will be a longer task than everyone expected, but, you know, it will gradually get sorted, but I don't think we've seen the pill yet that cures it all. And dollar, longer term, I think we see a strong dollar. Fed pending, stock markets higher. I do think we see oil go higher. I'm a big buyer of oil at the moment. Gold, I think, will probably ease back to the sort of 1480 area, and we look to carry on the year that way. Thank you very much.